My name is Steven. I'm 41. I'm from Eastern Ohio, and I have rhinophyma and rosacea on my nose. It feels like it's a giant piece of cartilage on the end of it. Just touch it or blow your nose or something that simple that most people take for granted, and it hurts. The weight that's on the edge of my nose is causing my nasal passages to close up to the point where I'm not breathing like a normal person, and it's causing me to sound a lot more nasally. For my job, I produce a retro gaming show.
3, 2, 1.
So if I can't talk or if I can't articulate words properly, then my audience is gonna suffer. Like most teenagers, I got acne, and it was very pronounced. That's when I first learned that I did have a form of rosacea. I had multiple treatments, from creams to medications. Over that time period, my nose was growing, and I pretty much have lost faith in any kind of dermatologist because nothing seemed to work. And since I know that there's nothing I can do about it, I have to make it as if it doesn't exist. Starting off good tonight, guys. I'm all ready to go here. Our goal is to grow the show. We want to see it go to the next level. And I feel like my nose is what's going to hold it back. My co-hosts, Glenn and Doug, they've never really come out and said anything about my nose. They accepted me how I was. I don't know how you did it, because I tried it for one of them.
You got to have that quick trigger finger, man.
But what if it gets to the point where I can't be on camera? It's just too large. I don't want to be the reason that this could fail. People make comments. I remember one of them was, this guy knows what's going on, and he spelled out N-O-S-E, and it takes that one person to send you into a downward spiral. What do you think? Daniel and I want to do a YouTube video. He wants to get some stuff set up down there, but we can use your help. I have two kids. I have a daughter named Samantha, who's 12, and I have a son whose name is Daniel, who's 8. You think you can set up the cameras?
Yeah.
You think?
All right. I hope.
You hope? We'll walk through it. Let's go. I've been torn over the last, couple of years because my wife and I, we teach our kids to love themselves where they're at. They're supposed to be accepting of how they are. All right, guys, so we're at Wild Card Video Games. So a new video segment I started doing with my wife. We'll go out to different mom and pop stores that are out there that are selling these older video games. Hey, Michael.
What's happening, man?
What's going on? What do you got for me today? My wife does the filming. She just shoots it with an iPhone. Let's see here. Yeah. I think I'm just gonna get these for now. And
no problem. 4838.
Okay.
Card, please, sir.
Okay.
All right, it's good.
Thanks,
to see
Mike.
You.
Do you see the way that guy was looking at me?
I did.
I don't understand it.
As his wife, seeing his confidence drop, it really kind of makes me mad. This is something that developed over time, and he can't help it. So when people make negative comments about it, it really hurts. I've seen you change, You seem the same on camera.
Because I have a job to do.
I know, but behind the scenes, though, your confidence has really gone down. And the kids have noticed.
Well, how do you think I feel?
I know. I just want to see you better mentally, and I want to see you better physically.
You teach your kids all these years that they need to accept themselves for who they are, and they need to love themselves and not worry about physical appearances. And here I am saying that you should be accepting of yourself, and then you're turning around and trying to correct something because of what people are saying. And what do you say to a child that asks you that because of what you've taught them? And that's hard. It's really hard.
Our kids support you 100%. I support you 100%. You know that.
I'm really excited to be here. I'm hoping Dr. Lee can reconstruct me the way I was meant to be.
So I'm just going to take your temperature.
Okay. I've gone through dermatologists growing up, and they swore to me that this was going to fix the problem, this was going to fix it. And so far, they've all come up short. And, I've seen Dr. Lee do marvelous work on a lot of different people. If she can't do it, I don't know who could.
Hello.
Hello.
Are you Steven?
I'm Steven.
Hi, nice to see you out here. I'm
see
Dr.
You.
Lee. Welcome. I'm gonna take my mask off, that's why we're out here. Do you wanna take yours off? Up to you. Okay. What brings you here? Your nose.
My nose.
Okay, do you know what this is?
Well, I've learned over the years it's Rhinophyma.
Okay. So Rhinophyma is associated with rosacea, and it's sort of a form of rosacea, but it typically happens in the nose, and you get a thickening of the skin, and it's really oily.
Yep.
How long have you had it?
About 10 years. So over the last couple of years, it seems to accelerate. I'm on camera all the time doing live shows on the internet.
So video. You see yourself.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah, but you know, you can't hide something that's big.
Yes.
It's obvious, even from where I'm sitting, that Steven's got rhinophyma. I mean, he has an enlarged nose. And the fact that his rosacea is still active is an issue because that's what is helping to sort of propagate his rhinophyma. Who knows when that will sort of burn out or whether that will be active throughout his long life and his rhinophyma gets worse.
Yes, this looks like rhinophyma.
Okay.
Lift your head up for me for a minute here. So yeah, you can kind of see where it's different. So we can remove a lot of this rhinophyma and try to reshape your nose. But my main concern really is I see that you're still pretty active here. Do you use anything right now for your rosacea? Do you try anything treatment? Because it's still active. Do you know what I mean? You're getting these red bumps like that, you know?
I'm gonna try to treat Steven's rhinophyma using my surgical electrocautery tool to really shave this down and re-sculpt his nose. But in Steven's case, I'm also looking at his active rosacea and making sure that whatever I do doesn't exacerbate that and also trigger more growth of his rhinophyma.
Let's see if we can't do something for you here.
I'm excited.
Okay?
I'm excited.
Okay. See you in a little bit, okay?
All right, thank you.
Of course.
Dr. Lee explained to me that I also have rosacea flare-ups, so it's good. It's good to know that. But right now, the biggest hope that I have is she doesn't run into any kind of complications because of that. I'm trying to keep the faith, you know?
All right, sweetie, you ready?
I think so.
I think you're
I'm
ready,
still
too.
Here.
Okay. I'm gonna do a little on top. That is ready.
It took some really careful sculpting, but I think I'm finally satisfied with the results here. When the swelling goes down, it's going to be revealed whether his nose has been properly shaped or not. So I'm hoping that he's gonna do really well, but you never really know with rosacea.
So remember, this is like swollen.
Yeah.
You can see the overall shape is good. Look at the size of your nostrils, they've opened up.
Oh, I can feel a difference.
But imagine, again, it's still puffed,
yes.
Obviously.
I know it's really swollen right now, but it's still night and day difference. I'm very excited. I feel like I've got a new lease on life. I'm really excited to see how the world receives it when I go back live and, you know, you waited all this time and now all of a sudden it's like, wham, it's here, it's done. Now go enjoy life.
We will put you on some anti-rosacea medications. One of the newer thoughts is that there's a mite that lives on our skin, all of us.
Oh, okay.
It's called a Demodex mite. There's a thought that people that have bad rosacea have more of these mites on their face. So we actually use an anti-mite medicine, a cream, to help to decrease the count of these mites on our skin.
I don't know if many people realize that there are mites that live on our skin. I'm talking about bugs, parasites. There's one in particular called the Demodex mite that lives in the skin of our face, and we believe that maybe these mites are a cause of rosacea. So some people with rosacea we're finding have more of these mites living on their skin.
So let's try that and see if that works.
Absolutely.
Dr. Lee said that I should take some medication to keep the rosacea under control so I don't have outbreaks, so I don't end up having a problem again in the future. The ball comes into my court, so I'm gonna do it. You know, I wanna do the preventative steps.
Thank you so much.
You're so welcome. I'm excited to see the result.
I won't be ashamed to be around my kids, my wife. They've helped me to realize, don't wait till it's out of control. Deal with it in the beginning. Life will be a lot simpler.